have no moment to reflect on what we've done the past few days, because for each workshop we didn't really have time, we didn't always have time to have a conclusion of the workshop or what we did, what we liked. And also, if you want to share stories as an artist in your home country of good practices that you want to share, so it's really an open moment to share the practices, but not in the room, but in the room. I don't know who wants to start.
Situation. For example, here with the special needs, with this special needs group and this funny, it's the same thing that I'm going through right now and having a special needs school and working with them. So for me, that was very special. I love moving. I am no music person, but I love my pig. Okay? I really love my pig. Every time I find out that we as a group learn from each art something more, and we grow with it, and we grow with each other. And I think that's the whole idea of these meetings, to grow with each other and to learn from each other. And it's very special. Thank you.
You're on. I'm part of many different collectives. I'm also part of the Belgium. And I was so happy to be in all the groups that I'm involved. We share this open source technologies. So basically, you all know that it's different from computer software, but you can take it to actually any sector or any activity that you do. And this aspect of sharing is, especially for young artists, I think it's more difficult because they're maybe more protective of their, or they're still finding the elements or the inspiration or something. But I think sharing is such an important moment because when you share, you can develop further. There's no losing points in that, because when you share, you can get that already polished up and the different branches and colors and whatever that you would yourself never would be developed. So I think meetings like this is really essential, and I think it's so much that it is practical. Because we can call to everybody's presentation or show how well we are doing one in another country, how many trajectories we do or how many kids we reach. But I think really sharing on such an open level, I think it's really crucial. Because like I thought about young track, but when you get older also, I think there's nothing to do. You have always something to do. But for me, personally, what is missing is inspiration. It's very difficult to get inspiration because you are constantly busy, you are constantly creating, you are constantly working, you need this and that. But to get inspired and maybe through inspiration of others question, okay, but how do I understand my practice? Is this an opportunity? Is this something that I could see how it touches me, or is it something totally new, or is it something that I still need to learn? I think this is a great question. So thank you very much for your
final analysis. So this was very new for me, and I was surprised our devotees in the group that we collaborate and participate at this meeting, like a group format before. I'm not explaining. Maybe. The group works like a group, but all together with so it was so symbolic, like we knew each other from here. I never seen something like this before.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I do different things in my life, so it's my first experience like this. But see people from different countries with different languages, different cultures that collaborate to one activity. Because at the first activity we collaborated all together. It was so beautiful. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yeah, I want to thank you all too, because this was like my first experience in that kind of form. It was, I didn't have a clue what I was up to when I said yes. So it was very interesting, and we talked about it to see how we all interacted. Like, we knew each other for a long time and we only knew each other since yesterday. That was kind of cool to see how it worked. Like, the music workshop and the counseling, and it's multilingual. Like, you don't need to speak one language to do it. You can do it with everyone. And, I love the workshops. But I was a little bit skeptical yesterday morning with the drawings and the. And then you saw that there's the first one was like straight and everyone thought he had to do something. And the other one, there was a connection between all of us. And that continued throughout the day until the end. And I like that. Yeah, because we are all crazy. We all have different stuff, but somehow in our heads we all crazy.
Some new input, even if there are methods like, oh yeah, I know that one, I use that one too, but then it's like 15 years ago, and then you think, oh no, it's not to do it again, and then you get energized for with the artist invited to explain Muse in the Art Academy in Antwerpen. And when we came there and walked around the apartments, and I was seeing, whoa, this is really, they are really still back in time. They are not of today. There is no connection. There is the painting department, there are the easels. The second year, there are little walls between them. The third year, the walls are a bit longer. The fourth year, each is in their own, and they don't talk anymore to each other. There is no connection. And I found it really difficult. And so we had a talk and about what we do with Muse. And then so there were like 20 young people. And then I said, and now we're going into action. And whoop, they all went. There were four who stayed to make a workshop like this. And it's, I feel there's still a lot of work to do, so I'm happy that we keep it going and keep the spirit, because it's the future. It's the past, only it's the past, but it stays the future. And it's I find it a pity that, because we in Muse Belgium, we have now a lot of young people from in their 20s, and I miss that, the very young ones that we have. But they have a lot of work, luckily. So Thursday, Friday, we are all in these kids. So, but yeah, this is the future. Thank you.
I just wanted to say that since the beginning of the Memory Foundation and of the Muse program, at the beginning there were not so many artists and not so many countries, so we used to organize once a year a big training seminar with all the artists, all the teachers, all the coordinators in the year 2000. It was like this. And then it was too much, too many. Singing voices or performing arts, and so each country would send two artists, and all together, I think it would so each country would send two artists on a specific discipline, artistic discipline, and we spend 3 years together exchanging the good practices. And now this third step is the one that Erasmus Plus has allowed, and especially thanks to the Fundación Unimedia España, who could find a way through the funding of Erasmus Plus to create a new generation of exchanges of good practices. And this is the one we have, step number three. So we can still invent many other ways of exchanging together. For example, as Patrice said before, from 2008 until 2012, I think, we've been organizing these voices concept, traveling in 7 countries every year during 6 years, exchanging our good practices with our different artist ambassadors in different settings, not only in school, but also in remote islands, remote valleys somewhere, and also in a hospital, in senior, in so many places. So there is a way to exchange our good practices, but as Patrice says, the spirit is there and it must be challenged all the time. It must be enriched with new approaches so that Muse will never die, as we all know, it will evolve. And I think not only Muse, but also the other practices that enrich together, like for example, yesterday you could see the approach of home plants. And we have not spoken so much of Ucreate, but we have one delegate of Ucreate here with us now, and which is a similar approach, but focusing more on music and residencies of 1 week, exchanging together and creating together new concepts based on music. And for string younger and younger artists, as Patrice said, because we have the older generation.
I would like to say thank you for all, because I when I see you all, each of your face, I remember one moment, one big moment of everyone. I don't know your lullaby or your bird voice, and a moment your big
voice.
So everybody, and it's a big moment for me, big inspiration for me. It's fantastic team. One of my biggest team or dynamic ever. So thank you so much. I don't like this ground, the noisy ground. it's just always a little bit nervous. I don't know. So it's hard, but it's not a big thing.
Primary school, I never paint because my teacher said you don't have the technique, you don't paint well. So I make that makes me feel afraid of painting. So past all that years, and in my I make a workshop with Barbara and the muse of Maya, and I found I can paint. So. It's a discovery, and so many discoveries every day about the rhythms, about the way to speak with the kids, with the special, the people with special education. I want to learn more, so thank you for giving me that opportunity.
It's a lot of work preparing and doing all the bureaucracy to get these things happening.
Especially in COVID times.
I wasn't here yesterday, but I wanted to come. But my boss at the school wouldn't let me take the time out because of COVID, not the teachers come. Anyway, when I received the invitation, I always say yes, because it's always very inspiring to meet other artists and share practices and get really inspired, because I think inevitably we do a lot of work on our own. I'm always very, I love these meetings. I've been to a few now, and I was glad to what Patrice said today, which was like, why can't you can express that way? Well, I think that's one of the wonderful qualities of Moose, is that she said we've given like a carte blanche to be able to work the way, and that's one of the things I've always loved with Moose, is that I can come in and really, you know, explore and experiment with the kids and discover new things of how you can, inspire children. The public you're working with to discover their own creativity. And And also, I hadn't thought that, but I think it's true that we need to think about younger generation, because this kind of work will only continue if we keep nurturing younger, more early generation to do it. And in Portugal, our big battle is always financial, getting funding in order to get people and enable more people to have work. But I think it's so important to have a project. And I really agree what Patrice says, is despite all these years, there's still, like what I see in schools as well, there's still the mentality, I find it still so limited in terms of inspiring and enabling students to really be creative and discover their own potential. Or everything you can do in the arts. So that's why I really think this kind of work is so essential. And I think it's more widely recognized as value.
Well, I wanted to thank you all for coming, first of all, because it's not always easy and with all the tests you have to do. So that, and you were also an easy and fun group to work with, so thank you. And I think these meetings, I'm not an artist like you, but it's sometimes very interesting because you always discover something about yourself, and it's always, since I started at the foundation and started to participate in this kind of trainings through Homelands and Capacitative, it's really to see the power of the arts. Like, for each workshop, I felt that they had the same goal, is to create the connection between people, to make something, and it's so easy to do it through drawing or theater or dancing or music, and everyone can relate to it, and sometimes we're scared like, oh, it's a drawing workshop, I can't draw. Actually, you can, it's just a line and another line, and you can do and create something together, and it's always nice to see that. And yeah, that's what I want to say. And also, like, I saw your workshop in Portugal, and then you had to adapt here because you didn't have any instruments, and it's very interesting to see how you adapt to the group or to the material we have, and how all of you are very creative. So, so thank you for all your input.
We had such a great experience, as she said. also you work in fact in political life, I think. When you think about art, it's very important to people's life, to make art to make their life better. And in the moment that we are living with COVID and everything, I think that it's very, very important, because they give out to some spaces for people to walk this house and also they don't know how things are going to be tomorrow or not. And art is something that you can put yourself, you can forget about that. And then also, I really enjoyed this different experience and like knowing more about the project from Barbara, for example. It's not to say that she's not an artist, but I think when you think about it, I think doing something with art is also art. Working with food is also art. I think that approach was the definition of what art is.
Brussels, where you can see most of them. So that's what I wanted to propose to you if you want. And then